The Pranava Upanishad, presented by Svayam Prakash Sharma. The Pranava Upanishad is about Om, and it belongs to the Atharved. The Upanishad consists of three Brahmanas or chapters. There are two recensions of the Upanishad that are available. Both are being uploaded as Pranav 1 and Pranav 2. The Upanishad is being uploaded in two parts. The first part consists of the first two Brahmanas, and the second and concluding part consists of the third Brahman. Source material for both these uploads has been obtained from 60 Upanishads of the Ved by Paul DEUSSEN. The Upanishad, first recension, part 1, consisting of the first and second Brahmans. Brahma created Brahma in a lotus flower. After being created, Brahma deliberated and thought, which is the one word by which all desires are obtained, and by which all worlds, all gods, all the Vedas, all knowledge, all the sacrifices, all the rewards of the sacrifices, everything that is movable and everything that is immovable is known. To know that word, Brahma practiced tap. He practiced austerities. After he had practiced tap, he saw that word Om, which consists of two letters and four mores or sounds. The word which is all encompassing, the word which is all ruling, the word which is always new, and the word which is Brahm. Then, knowing the word Om, Brahma obtained all desires. He obtained all the worlds. He obtained all the gods. He obtained all the Vedas, all the knowledge. He obtained all the sacrifices. He obtained all that is movable and all that is immovable. Through the first letter of the word Om, he perceived and knew water or apas, and he knew acquisition. He saw and he knew water, and he acquired everything that is to be acquired. Through the second letter of the word, he perceived and he knew fire and light. The first more, the first sound of the Om word is the A sound. It is the earth and the fire. It is the plants and all the vegetation. It is the Rig Ved. It is Bhur. It is the Gayatri meter. It is the nine-lettered Sam mantra. It is the east direction. It is the spring season. And with reference to the self or the Atma, it is the language, it is the tongue, and it is the speech. The second more, or the second sound of Om, is the U sound. It is the atmosphere and the wind. It is the Yajurved. It is Bhuvar. It is the Tristub meter. It is the 15-lettered Sam mantra. It is the western direction. It is the summer season. And with reference to the self or the Atma, it is the breath. It is the nose. It is the smell. The third more, or the third sound of Om, is the M sound. It is the heaven and the sun. It is the Sam Ved. It is Swar. It is the Jagati meter. It is the 17-lettered Sam mantra. It is the northern direction. and it is the rainy season. With reference to the self or the Atma, it is the light, it is the eye, and it is the sight. The fourth more or the fourth sound of Om is the Anuswar, or the dot above the word Om. It is the water and the moon. It is the Atharved. It is Janas. It is the Anustubh meter. It is the 27 lettered Sam mantra. It is the southern direction, and it is the autumn season. And with reference to the self or the Atma, it is the heart. It is the knowledge, and it is all that is known. The reverberation of the sound of Om, or the echo of the sound of Om, is the Vedangas. It is the limbs of the Vedas. It is both creation as well as dissolution. It is the discourse on the Vedas. It is the great formulas. It is the Upanishads. It is the Vedic injunctions. It is the seven Viharthis. It is the seven tones. It is art and dance. It is speech and music. It is the songs of Chitrarth, the king of the Gandharvas, the forest spirits, and of the other Gandharvas as well. It is the lightning. It is the Brihati. It is the 33-lettered Saman mantra. It is the direction leading upwards. It is the 4 months of the remaining seasons. And with reference to the self or the Atma, it is the ear. It is the voice. And it is the hearing. This pranav, Om, this one word Om, originated before the tapas, before the austerity. It is the Brahm, the soul of the Atma, the soul of the universe. It is the Atma of the universe. It is the seed of all the Vedas. All the mantras have sprung from this very pranav, from this very Om. And this is the quality of pranav. When one studies the Vedas without tap, without austerity, without devotion, when one studies the Vedas without attending to the teacher or at a forbidden, inappropriate time, then the power of the Veda, the power of such learning for such a person, diminishes. He does not get the full benefit of the teaching, and the teaching does not remain with him. He forgets the teaching. But through the pranav, which is the essence of the Atharved, the person gets back the power of all that he has learned, and then the teaching remains with him. He never forgets that teaching. And just as a child in the mother's womb, if its position at the time of birth is not proper and correct, it can have disastrous consequences for the mother, to the extent of even killing her during childbirth. But if the position of the child at birth is proper and correct, then it is born easily and causes no harm to the mother and frees her from its burden. Similar is the case of the mantras. Their study goes through well, through the pranav, and their effect remains in the case of the sacrifices performed, and such sacrifice becomes faultless. Therefore it is said of the pranav, the pranav is the one word that is recited at the beginning of each and every sacrifice, and also at the end of each and every sacrifice. The syllable of the hymn in the highest heaven, on the support of which all the gods in heaven sit on their thrones, If one does not know this syllable, then of what use is the hymn for such a one? We who know it are all assembled here. This syllable, this word is the word Pranav. This word is the word Om. He who desires something, he should observe abstinence for 3 days and nights. He should sleep on straw. He should sit silently facing the east. And every night, he should recite the Pranav 1,000 times in his mind. It is then that he will receive the objects of his desire, and it is then that he will obtain the fruit of his sacrificial acts. It so happened that once the asuras, the demons, who represented the forces of dark, they surrounded Sudha, which is heaven, the city of Indra, from all sides. There was a real danger that the asuras would overrun the city. Indra then rallied the gods behind Om, the firstborn of Brahm, who was also the strongest amongst them. And through the leadership of Om, the gods were able to repulse the attack of the asuras and defeat them and thus save heaven. In gratitude for saving heaven and for leading them to victory over the asuras, the gods decreed, "Since you, Om, have led us to this victory over the asuras, henceforth, from now onwards, you will lead in every study of the Vedas and in every sacrifice. Therefore, anyone who studies the Vedas must first recite Om before he starts his study. And every sacrifice performed also must be preceded by recitation of the word Om. Therefore, one says the word Om before beginning any sacred activity. And one who does not know this and begins the sacred activity without reciting the word Om, be sure that he would not be able to complete the sacred activity. But one who knows the Pranav Om, he has the Vedas in his power. He has all the knowledge of all the Vedas in his power. That is why, when at the beginning of the Rig Veda, if a person recites the Pranav Om, then it becomes the Rig Veda. In the same manner, if one recites the Pranav Om at the beginning of the Yajurveda, the Samved, or the Atharved, then it becomes the Yajurved, the Samved, and the Atharved. And also, in every work, because one recites the Pranav Om at the beginning of that work, it becomes in effect the form of that work. Yes, it becomes in effect the form of that work. This concludes the first part of the first recension of the Pranav Upanishad, consisting of the first two Brahmans, Om, Shanti, 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 Om.